Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Allah ke naam se shuru jo nihayat meherban hamesha rehm farmane wala hai.
It is much more rewarding. It will be more, you will get more ajr for your attendance in the masjid if you do your wudu at home. There is a hadith of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if one walks to the masjid, he gets the reward for each and every step. Each and every step, the reward he gets, ajr he gets, is the reward like he has fasted for a whole year. For a whole year. That ajr, can you imagine? If you are walking to the masjid, it does not mean now you have to come all the way from Channelstown walking every Jummah. And Brother Al-Qadri, doesn't mean you have to come from Hong Kong all the way walking now. This is not what the hadith tells us. The hadith, in those times, people, the masjid used to be in the same city, small city, Medina. And people obviously used to come by walk. The city of Medina was so small that today the Masjid al-Nabawi Sharif, Masjid al-Nabawi Sharif, today it's so huge, so big. The actual city of Medina, is much smaller than the Masjid al-Nabawi Sharif of today. So when the Prophet said to his Sahaba this, you will get ajr for every step you take towards the masjid when you are walking. There was no other way for them to come except walking. Do they need to bring horses when you have to travel only 200-300 meters maximum? No. So the reason why he said walking was because that was the only way. But in every time, people may travel in different forms, different vehicles. How much reward will they get? Will they get the reward per kilometer? Per 100 meter? Per 10 meters? No, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, even they will get reward according to each human footstep. So they may travel in the vehicles, but if you calculate the footsteps, that is the amount of reward they will get for Jummah. Can you imagine? If you come from Charlestown, how much reward you get? Because each step is like you get the ajr of 1 year fasting. 1 year of fasting. And you know, this hadith, you may hear it and you may forget it. But let me tell you. 1 year of fasting, if I tell you go fast next whole week, will you be able to fast whole week? If it's not farad, you will struggle. You will struggle, brothers. You will really struggle. Without your struggling and effort, without you putting any extra effort, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh my servant, do you know I am Rahman, I am Rahim. I am the most compassionate, ever merciful. I know that you are very sinful. Mankind is very sinful. And I know that mankind is leading towards the hell. You are leading towards hell. Your actions, your deeds, your life is disobedience of Allah. But remember, I am so forgiving. Every Jummah, every Friday, I give you again a chance to extraordinarily get more ajr from me. Extraordinary. So on the day of judgment, when that accountability will take place, on that day of judgment, you may think now you are doing just coming for Jummah. You are getting just the reward of coming for Jummah. But you don't know and don't realize that the hadith of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, on the day of judgment, you think only you went to Jummah once a week, but you will see their ajr of many years of fasting. Many years of fasting. Why? Because Allah is looking of ways to forgive us. He is looking. He is trying. Allah is trying all the time to try to forgive us. But yet, how unfortunate are people that yet they forget Allah Ta'ala. Yet they have forgotten Allah Ta'ala. He is so compassionate, so merciful. He changes his laws. No other ummah of any other prophet used to get the reward of Jummah like this. They don't even have Jummah. What to talk about the reward of Jummah? They didn't have Jummah. This blessed day is only among one of those khasais al-Muhammadi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is a speciality of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His ummah only gets the blessed day of Friday. No other. And I am not only talking about the attending at the masjid. Imagine how much your reward gets right now when you are listening to the khutbah, when you are in the masjid, in the state of purification. When the reward of coming to the masjid is so much, each and every step, the reward of hajj is so much. Imagine how much a reward it is when you are sitting here. You cannot imagine that. The next thing. First thing, when you enter the masjid, you must enter with your right foot. It's a sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you must say the dua. Allahumma aftahli abwaab rahmati. Oh Allah, I ask you, open your doors of rahmah on me, mercy on me. And you can do, you can intend, Ya Allah, the amount of time I'm spending in the masjid, I intend to do nafal itikaf. Any voluntary itikaf, then you spending time in the masjid, whether it is 5 minutes or 50 minutes or 1 hour, it will be also considered as itikaf. If the khutbah has not started, if you are fortunate to come before that, if the khutbah has not started, to read Surah Al-Kahf. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the person who recites Surah Kahf on the day of judgment, there will be noor appearing for him. This noor will help him on the day of judgment. It will guide him on the day of judgment in that darkness. If the khutbah has already started, this is important. I see many brothers doing, some brothers doing it now, right now. If the khutbah has started, you cannot pray salah. Whether it is sunnah, it is nafal, you cannot do that during the khutbah. Because according to Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, it is wajib to listen to the khutbah on Jum'ah. It is wajib. And wajib supersedes sunnah. It's 4 rakat sunnah of Zuhr. They are only sunnah. Wajib, remember we talked about classification of Islamic ahkam. We discussed fard, wajib, sunnah, muqidah, ghair muqidah, mustahab, mubah, nafal, haram, etc. Among them, there is one which is sunnah, and then there is wajib. Wajib, which was it higher or was it lower than sunnah? Wajib. Do you remember?
Wajib is higher.
It was higher. Ahead. So wajib supersedes. So it is wajib to listen to the khutbah. You can't pray at this moment when the khutbah is taking place. You can pray after the salat. Or you should have come before. People say, but we don't get the time. But it's not the fault of the imam or the masjid that you haven't come on time. It's your fault. You should have come earlier, so you have enough time to pray for rakat sunnah. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned the importance of Jummah salat. I think I discussed this in detail last week. I mentioned this Quranic verse. Then there are many hadiths, and I just would like to very quickly go through them. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever baths, we discussed on Jummah, take a bath, take a shower, apply oil or gel or an perfume, fragrance. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is in Bukhari, whoever goes to the masjid in the state of purification while he is having put fragrance on him, and he arrives at the masjid, he does not sit down by removing anyone from his place. And wherever he finds a place, closer to the imam. Not when you come and you find the mosque is empty and you sit in the corner like that. But closer to the imam, closer in the front. What happens then? And he prays after the Salatul Jummah, nafal prayers as much as possible. When the imam, or before that, when the imam delivers khutbah, he remains silent. Then his sins from the previous Jummah until this Jummah will be forgiven. Next, Rasulullah Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he narrates, and Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they narrate that they heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, people should abstain from leaving out Jummah salat. You should not deliberately unattend Jummah salat. You must attend it. If a person does deliberately leave out, does not attend Jummah, what a salat, what happens is Allah will put a seal on his heart. Allah will put a seal, and there is another hadith which tells us, for every Jummah you deliberately leave out, one black mark dot on your heart is marked. When you do more than 3 times regularly you leave out Jummah, 2 things happen. Number one, you are labeled among the angels. They label you, they give you a title. munafiq. And can you imagine how severe it is to leave out Jummah? We discussed last week that in the law, in eyes of Allah, Jummah, the day of Jummah, is more blessed than the day of Eid. We discussed in detail this. We discussed that attending Jummah is more important than attending Eid. But people are nowadays the opposite way. People think it is more important to come on Eid. On Eid there are hundreds of people. On Jummah there are only few people. We have to change our mindset, brothers and sisters. Jummah is so important that the Prophet ﷺ said, in the law, in the eyes of Allah, Jummah is more important than Eid. And this is why, for Eid, the Prophet never said, whoever does not go for Eid, he will become a hypocrite. No. But he will leave out his reward. That's it. But for the rest, a person who does leave out, who does not attend Jummah Salat, he is the person who will become a munafiq. And he will get a seal on his heart. What does this seal mean? What does it mean when your heart gets a seal? It means that now you do not feel any peace, tranquility in the dhikr of Allah. There are people who would say, we pray, but we don't really feel any blessing. And we pray, we read Quran, but we don't really feel anything. Or we cannot cry. There are people, they say, we can't cry. We try, but we can't just cry. I don't know why we can't cry. But one of the reasons why you can't cry, in the khawf, in the fearness of Allah, and when you think about the day of judgment, you do not cry, it's because your heart has become that sealed heart. Now you have to get rid of that seal. How? Again, tawbah. Ruju, go back to Allah, repent to Allah. And because Allah is the one who put the seal, He is the one who can remove that seal from you. Rasulullah said, the person who misses out three Jummahs without any valid reason, Allah puts a seal over his heart. This is in Tirmizi. And another hadith tells us that Allah becomes displeased with him. Ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Abbas, he is the companion of Rasulullah, who was known as the Mufassir of the Quran, who was known as the greatest commenter of Quran, the one who understands the Quran, who gives tafsir of the Quran, explains the Quran. You know what he said? He was asked once, what do you say about a person who did not join Jummah Salat? Who passed away and who did not join Jummah Salat? A person who didn't join Jummah Salat and it was not his habit and he would deliberately not attend Jummah and he dies. What do you say? What do you say about him? Sayyidina Ibn Abbas, he says, huwa finnar. That person is in hell. This person continued asking him. Ibn Abbas was asked this question by this person every day almost, for a whole month. And Ibn Abbas a whole month said, huwa finnar. Why the whole month? The hadith is important. Why? It doesn't mean that that person was always in hell. No, not that. Because we know all Muslims, من قال لا إله إلا الله فهو دخل الجنة. He will go ultimately to paradise. But this means that the punishment for not going for Jummah, one Jummah, is equal to at least 1 month of being in hell. This is what this narration means. Next thing, advocates of